Hello friends, this is Kishore Kumar here. Welcome back to my channel K-Cops Vlogs. Today on what topic I'm going to discuss, you already know by seeing the thumbnail, but still I want to tell you that Royal Enfield Himalayan. This vehicle specification and my point of view, good review and bad review, all included in this vlog. Starting with the specification, let's start with instrument cluster, RPM meter, fuel gauge, trip navigation system, compass, Bluetooth. These all are there, but USB charging port is not there. I'm little bit disappointed on this. Royal Enfield's neighbor kit, the Xpulse 200 only having a USB port, but Royal Enfield its own kit don't have. Once we buy this Himalayan, we definitely thinking about traveling for a long distance. While traveling long distance, we need GPS. For GPS, we need mobile. To charge mobile, we need charging port. Anyway, this problem can be solved out of the showroom. We can connect this USB charging port separately. This vehicle comes with six different colors: rock red, lake blue, gravel gray, Pinny Green, Mirage Silver, Granite Black. In all this, my favorite is Mirage Silver, and I am driving that one only. Himalayan is having a long travel suspension which give you a confidence to travel any corner of India. Not only off-road, on-road also you will be having a nice drive experience. 41mm telescopic front suspension fork is having a travel potential of 200mm, which will help you to bring you out from any type of difficult terrain. Monocross with the linkage 180mm rear wheel suspension also work like front. This vehicle ground clearance is 220mm. You can go to any type of hard terrain and come out of it, either off-road or on-road, whichever it may be. This vehicle's upshift silencer will help you to come out of difficult terrain which consists with water. 411cc long stroke single cylinder vehicle which comes with 4-stroke air-cooled, equipped with digital electronics ignition system and 5-speed mesh gearbox, so this vehicle gear shifting will be much better. Max power 24.3 bhp at 6500 rpm, max torque 32 Nm at 4000 to 4500 rpm. This vehicle's front wheel 21 inch, rear wheel 17 inch. Even the 411cc engine, this vehicle's full potential can be judged with the good brake. Front, it comes with 300mm disc 2 piston floating clipper. Rear, 240mm disc single piston floating clipper will give you better control on this vehicle. Even though good power and disc brake won't give a thrust like ABS, dual channel switchable to single channel ABS, rear wheel ABS deactivation will allow you to activate and deactivate whenever you need. Curb weight 199 kg, fuel capacity 15 liter, wheelbase 1465 mm, length 2190 mm, width 840 mm, height 1370 mm, seat height 800 mm. Dual purpose seat tire is there so that you can travel 50% on-road, 50% off-road, wherever you wish to. These all are this vehicle's specification. By look and feel, this vehicle looks pretty big, but average Indian can able to ride Royal Enfield Himalayan. I would like to share few Himalayan riders review with you. Due to very good initial torque, if you are climbing uphill and you want to climb it slowly, this vehicle will take you there without hassle. Still using the classic old spokes wheel, tube tire, circled rear view mirror, halogen circled classic headlight, makes people to think when these people come out of this old tradition. This vehicle's previous variant had some issue with the relays and fuse, but nowadays new vehicles are coming without those type of issues. After reaching 110 km, this vehicle will start vibrating. If you are a person who drives between 80 to 100, then this vehicle is awesome. You can take it to anywhere you want to go. After driving around half an hour, you will realize to feel this vehicle's engine heat. But anyway, it's not unbearable. You can wear jeans pant and use this vehicle. This vehicle wheelbase is big, so turning radius also big. When you are turning, be careful, else there may be a chances you may fall down. Himalayan displacement 411cc, so its competitor are very less, but still KTM 390 Adventure, BMW 310 GS is closest to it, but still for the price what you give, this is value for the money. In a city commute, this vehicle will give max 32 mileage. For a highway use, it will give more than a 40 km mileage. Small drawbacks which I have addressed, it can be fixed out of the showroom. If you are a person who is going to cruise from 90 to 100 range and you are ready to afford this vehicle, this is a very budget friendly and mileage vehicle for a long distance travel. Before buying this vehicle, make sure you have a test drive and check with your friend circle before taking a final call on buying this vehicle. I will catch you in another video. This is Kishore Kumar here. You are watching KCOPS Vlogs.